This is Royden with Gadget360 and this is a review of the Moto X Style. Motorola has reserved their Moto X moniker for their flagship phones. However, this year we've seen a slight change in that philosophy. The company launched two handsets with the Moto X branding, the Moto X Play, which is more of a budget upper mid-range phone, and of course the Style, which is their new flagship. Today, we have the third generation of the device, but instead of calling it Gen 3, Motorola has gone with the name Moto X Style or Pure Edition as it's known in some countries. The one thing we really love is that Motorola has stuck with its iconic design language, which makes the Moto X Style instantly recognizable. It's not a head turner by any means, and one could easily mistake it for a Moto G Gen 3. This is only in terms of looks though, as the phone feels very premium when you actually hold it. So should you jump ship from the Moto X Gen 2 to the Moto X Style? And more importantly, does the new phone solve all our grievances that we had with this previous one? Let's find out. The metal frame and soft touch rubber back feel very comfortable and give you adequate grip too. The Moto X Style is also noticeably heavier at 179 grams and fatter, measuring 11.1 millimeters in thickness. There are three infrared sensors spread along the edges of the front fascia, which are used to activate Moto Display. Moto Display works as you expect. The phone lights up when you reach for it or simply hover your palm over it. This is super useful if you just want to view your incoming messages and dismiss them without even having to turn the screen on. The Moto X Style packs in a 21 megapixel primary camera, which is lifted from the Moto Turbo. There's also a dual LED flash unit just beneath the sensor, followed by the Motorola logo. Finally, there's a non-removable 3000 mAh battery underneath the back cover. The Moto X Style now has a Quad HD TFT display. The size of the display has been bumped up from a 5.2 to 5.7 inches. We are a little disappointed that they didn't stick to the AMOLED panel like their earlier flagships. Don't get us wrong, the display is very good in terms of brightness levels and color saturation, but we miss the inky blacks and vividness that we're used to on Motorola's previous flagships. Another issue with having a TFT instead of AMOLED is that Moto Display tends to wake up the entire screen rather than just the pixels where the notifications appear. Last but not the least, there's also Corning Gorilla Glass 3 for protection. The bundle charger supports Motorola's Turbo Power feature, which promises 8 hours of use with a 15-minute charge. The Motorola Moto X Style rocks a relatively new Qualcomm Snapdragon 808 SoC, which is a hexa-core chip with 4 ARM Cortex-A53 cores and 2 ARM Cortex-A57 cores. The Moto X Style finally gets expandable storage, which is one of our biggest gripes about the Gen 2 Moto X. There's 3GB of RAM and 16 or 32GB of onboard storage, depending on which model you pick. You can also expand storage by up to 128GB. Call quality is good and the phone easily latched onto 4G networks whenever possible. There's also LTE support on band 40 for both SIM slots. Android purists will really love the Moto X Style for its Nexus-like software. You get vanilla Android 5.1.1 out of the box with a guaranteed update to Android 6.0 Marshmallow. Motorola has added its usual suite of apps including Connect and Migrate and a new consolidated app called Moto. Moto Voice is similar to Google's voice search feature, which lets you perform tasks like making calls or searching the web by simply speaking to it. You can set up a launch phrase which wakes up the voice assistant when the phone is in standby. Moto Actions now lets you turn on the torch by performing a double karate chop gesture, while Moto Assist can automatically perform a set of preset tasks when you're driving, in a meeting, or sleeping. The performance of the phone is really good. The Moto X Style easily handles demanding games and apps and pretty much anything you throw at it with ease. However, if you look at it purely in terms of numbers, the Snapdragon 808 SoC is not a giant leap forward when compared to, let's say, the 805 or even the 801, which was powering the second gen Moto X.
With no custom skin bogging Android down, performance is very snappy. The interface is smooth with no noticeable stutter in transitions and when multitasking. The phone handles demanding games and apps very well.
We did notice that the phone gets warm pretty easily. Even watching standard definition videos for extended periods of time can cause the screen and the back of the phone to get warm easily.
The Snapdragon 808 SoC posts some good numbers in benchmarks. The performance improvement isn't much when compared to its predecessor. The phone handles video playback very well. All our test files, including the high bitrate ones, played without a hitch. Watching videos or listening to music is especially enjoyable thanks to the front-firing stereo speakers. The sound doesn't distort at high volumes and is easily audible even in noisy environments. The audio and video player is from stock Android Lollipop, although Motorola has added an audio effects option in the settings app. This lets you tweak the audio for the headset and the speaker. Speaking of the headset, audio quality is quite average and the earbuds don't really sit in your ear comfortably. The Moto X Style sports front-facing stereo speakers as well as an LED flash for the front-facing 5-megapixel camera. The 21-megapixel camera looks great on paper, but in reality, it's strictly average when compared to other flagship phones. Landscapes and macros look good on the phone's display, but zooming in reveals a lot of missing details. The post-processing in the camera tends to make a mess of finer details in the picture. Motorola has also stuck with the same annoying autofocus system, which feels outdated when compared to other implementations. You have to drag the reticule around to focus, as tapping on the screen will immediately take a picture. Low light shots aren't very good either and appear blotchy. We do like the half carousel design for quickly changing the camera settings. For video, we now have 4K support along with 1080p and 720p slow motion. Recorded videos are good, especially 4K, but slow motion videos are pretty poor. It's not about the resolution being limited to 720p, but more to do with the quality itself, which appears interlaced.
Battery life is another area where the Moto X Style falls a bit short. We managed to get just under 8 hours in our video loop test, which is a bit less considering the 3000 mAh battery in the phone. Now, some of the reasons for this could be due to the power-hungry hexa-core SoC and even the fact that the phone does have a Quad HD display.
The Motorola Moto X Style is far from the home run we were expecting. We like that the company has only made things better by adding metal to the construction. The phone also checks all the boxes when you consider expandable storage, 4G LTE, gentle performance and a good display. But is this enough to make it a must-have for those shopping in the Rs 30,000 segment?
If you're looking for a pure Android experience, why not go for the Nexus 6? Sure, it's a bit older, but it does match the style in all the key specifications. Plus, you'll also have the added advantage of getting preferential treatment from Google each time a new flavor of Android rolls out. The unexciting camera and average battery performance continue to haunt Motorola's flagship phones, which is actually holding the style back from being an otherwise very good all-rounded package. So that is our review of the Motorola Moto X Style. Do subscribe to our channel for more video reviews, and also don't forget to follow us on Twitter and Facebook at Gadgets360.